On 6 December 2011, at 12:45 p.m., I was called by the Lord to come and meet him. This was during the conference that was going on. So I stole myself away from the conference and went to my room. And as I entered into my room, I saw 2 mighty angels standing there. And they beckoned me to go to the balcony. He said, "The Lord is standing there. Go and meet him there." So I went to the balcony and I saw the Lord Jesus Christ standing very regally. And he beckoned me, "Come and stand beside me." And when I stood, he said, "Look at my beautiful city." So I looked around from the hotel, you know, high rise, you can see the nice, beautiful city. As I was watching, suddenly there was a huge explosion, a bomb drop, and a building exploded. Another bomb drop, another building exploded. The whole city was gone up in smoke. War planes were flying here and there. And the Lord Jesus said, "My city will suffer the pain of war." Then the angels were standing by. They said, "In the war, Israel will put up stiff fight amidst heavy losses. A political trap will be laid for the city to be captured. And Israel's best friend will betray her." Israel has only one best friend. And her best friend will betray her. You know, if you have ever read Shakespeare's plays, one of the plays is Julius Caesar. And Julius Caesar had a best friend called Brutus. Towards the end of the play, the ministers will concord a plan to assassinate Julius Caesar. And somehow, they will bribe Brutus to be part of their company of assassination. And Brutus and Julius Caesar were the best and the thick of friends. And Julius Caesar trusted his life in Brutus' hands. When all these other guys came and stabbed Julius Caesar, Julius Caesar was still standing boldly and fighting, you know. And then finally Brutus came and he laid his dagger into Julius Caesar's flesh. And Julius turned around and said, "You too, Brutus." And he dropped dead. What killed Julius Caesar was not the stabbing from all these other guys, but the fatal wound from his best friend. Fatal wound, the betrayal by his best friend, totally killed him. If not, a mighty man of Julius Caesar cannot die like that. But the betrayal by his best friend totally broke his heart to pieces. In the same manner, the political trap that will be laid for Israel, her best friend will lay that trap. And she will be betrayed by her best friend. Then the son of perdition, her best friend, will come to offer peace, land for peace deal. This happened once in history. After the 6-day war, the UN Security Council passed a resolution, 242, made on November 22, 1967, a land for peace agreement. When this will be done, very soon, Daniel chapter 9 verse 27 will be fulfilled. It will be fulfilled in the war. Then the angels who were standing by said to me, Even now, the son of perdition is making plans with the beasts for this to happen. UN will gather the nations to force Israel to divide Jerusalem. This has been prophesied in Amos chapter 7 verse 17. You know, when this word was spoken to me, in a vision I saw the Israeli Prime Minister desperately hoping and trusting their best friend will stand by their side to help them. He'll be so helpless. He'll be like in a cornered position, not knowing what to do. He can't stand up and declare that Jerusalem cannot be divided anymore. He's so helpless. In the midst of the helplessness, the best friend comes with a political trap. And the Israeli Prime Minister will trust their best friend and accede to that demand, not knowing that it was a trap. Now, what will be the aftermath of dividing Jerusalem? It will be divided. What will be the aftermath? Great earthquakes will take place in many, many places around the world, especially in the nations that will be involved in creating, conniving this plan to divide Jerusalem. It will be followed by great tidal waves of tsunami coming to cause great devastation. You know, when these words were spoken, prior to the prophetic conference that we conducted in Egypt near Mount Sinai last December, I was fasting for 3 days up on the mountain prior to the conference. And one morning, I was sitting by a rock, sipping a cup of tea and meditating the word of God. And suddenly, I saw an open vision. Right before my eyes, I saw a mighty angel with a long drawn sword in his hand. And he stood before me, speaking all these words, and then he said, "This is what will happen to the best friend that will betray Israel and divide Jerusalem." When he spoke those words, I saw this map of US, like in a three-dimensional, you know. It appeared right before my eyes, beside the angel, and he took the sword and pierced right into the heart of US and cut into two. He said, "Likewise will this nation be divided as Jerusalem will be divided." Cut the land into two, exactly in the center.